Hello, and again, we're excited to spend some time with you studying the Old Testament, more specifically, the people of the Old Testament. And today we begin the study of another of the prophets. We'll talk about how God changed and gave responsibility from one person to another, and we'll see it today in our study. But let's pray, and we'll begin today. Heavenly Father, we pause at your feet today. We wait for you to speak to us so we can hear the words from you today. We need you today. And we pray as we study the people of the Old Testament that you will speak to our hearts about what we are doing with our lives today. We pray that you would help us to improve and to walk closer with you today as a result of this study. I thank you for the many people who are watching today by video. We pray that you would bless them and help them to grow and to mature in Christ. And I pray that you would help me to do the same. Help us as we walk with you to know you better and better and better, and to change more and more of our behavior and our lives. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. All right. We're going to begin today. You know, as I think about this topic that we're going to talk about today, I think about Elijah. Elijah. We talked about him last week. Elijah was a faithful prophet of God. He was faithful for many, many years. You remember last week we talked about how he prayed for fire to come down from heaven and consume his offering on the altar there, and how God did that. And he was victorious over the 850 prophets and priests of Baal. We talked about how Baal was a false god and how Elijah stood for the real God, the only God in heaven. You know, today not much has changed. You and I need to stand for God today, still the same as Elijah stood back in those days. And so I want to encourage you as you think about your life and what difference you are making, think about the life of Elijah. He's a real encouragement for us. Elijah did the work of God during his lifetime. But now Elijah, he's not here. So God is depending on you and me and other believers to stand in the right place and do the right things for God. And I want to encourage you today, you are important to the plan of God. But as we look back, we see Elijah. Elijah was becoming older, and God needed to replace him with another person. One thing to impress on you right now as we think about these prophets, God will always choose to use people. And when one person becomes old or something happens, God will find another person. God is interested in his message going through the time of the ages of history. And God will use you and me today if we are willing and we are clean for him to use. So today I want to introduce you to a second prophet. First was Elijah. The second, his name is almost the same. It's Elisha. So we need to come up with a sign name for, we have Elijah, Elisha. We're going to sign Elisha today, Elisha. That'll be for Elisha. So what happens is Elijah has become older and his time is drawing to an end and God is going to replace him. Elijah had become an old man, but he meets a younger man named Elisha. And he was, when he first met him, he was plowing in the fields with his ox, and he surrendered and followed Elijah. For several years, Elijah trained and taught and passed on to Elisha all the things that he had learned from God. And as he taught Elisha listened and learned and tried to improve. But Elijah knew, my time is coming to an end, and I need to pass on what I know to the younger man. One of the problems that we face in our world today is that older men have not passed on to the younger men what they have learned from God. Some older people think, oh, I don't know about the technology today. I don't know about all of the things that everybody is talking about today. I'm not connected with the world today. I'm not going to worry about it. The young people are so smart today. They don't need me. That's wrong. The older people have something younger people cannot have. What? They have experience. They have learned from doing things right and wrong. Stay away, follow this. And they need to teach the younger people those things. I want to encourage you today. This lesson today emphasizes for me the importance that we have to learn, yes. But then after we have learned, we have to pass it on to other people. So that truth continues on through time. And it doesn't stop with us. I want to encourage you today to look and see who can you influence for Christ with what you have learned in your life. Find a person and tell them what you know, especially deaf people sharing with other deaf people. I remember a time I was teaching a Bible truth, and I tried the best I could to explain it as clear as possible. I remember after class was finished, I thought myself, oh, I taught that pretty clearly. But then later I noticed that there were two deaf men over on the side, and one was older, the other was younger, and the older was explaining my lesson I had just taught and thought, oh, I did pretty good on that, made it clear. No, he was making it clearer. He was explaining it deeper. And I watched, and at first I thought, wow. I thought I taught it the best, but later I understood. I thought, no, it's good. A deaf man explained to other deaf man the truths that I had taught in a better way than me. And really, that's exciting. That is our responsibility. Elijah had learned many things from God in his experience and his time with serving and leading. And now he was going to pass on to Elisha the things that he had learned himself. And that's what real leaders should do. Leaders should train and teach other leaders. Let me show you a verse from the New Testament that really speaks about this. I love these verses too. They're both from 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1 and 2. It says, "Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus." First, I want you to see this: an older person with experience teaching a younger person. He calls my son. He says, "Thou therefore, my son," and then he encourages, "Be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus." He goes on, verse 2, "And the things that thou hast heard of me or from me among many witnesses, the same commit thou to faithful men who shall be able to teach others also." Do you see how this is like a chain? The older person starts, he passes on to a younger man. He passes on to another man. He passes on to another man, and it keeps on going. The things you have heard from me, pass on. I remember when I was a boy, my father and I would go outside after dinner. We'd go outside, we were going to play maybe football. We'd throw back and forth and catch. My father would teach me how to throw. He would teach me how to catch right, how to kick the ball, how to do different things. Later, my wife and I had a son. And our son and I, we would go out, I would teach him how to throw. Wait, where did I learn from? From my father. He passed to me, I passed to my son, and so on and so on. And that's what it says here. The things you have heard from me among many, many witnesses, the same you need to commit or give to other faithful men who will be able to teach also. So we see here in our story, Elijah, the older, and Elisha, the younger. And the Bible truth is that we need to be willing to pass on to others the things we have learned. One person said, there is no success without a successor. If you learn and learn and learn many wonderful things about the Bible and you hold them for yourself and you don't share them with other people and you keep it for yourself, you don't pass it on, when you die, all those truths with you die. But if you have been following this, you will give it to a person who is younger than you and follows and lives longer. And what happens? That truth that you held, you pass on, it gets passed on and passed on and passed on, and it keeps going. And that truth continues through the years. If you hold it and you don't give it, it dies with you. And so it was true with Elijah and Elisha. And I want to tell you, Elisha was preparing himself to replace Elijah. And so what happened was Elisha followed and followed and followed Elijah. And we see it all through the Bible. Elisha wanted to make sure he learned all that he could from Elijah while Elijah was still here on the earth. And so there were many, many times that Elijah said to Elisha, go away, don't follow me so much. But he refused. I believe because God had touched Elisha's heart to know Elijah is important. You need to learn from him, follow him. And he was stubborn. He would not leave. And so the Bible tells us that there were three times that I have read as I study the story where Elisha said to Elijah, I will not leave thee. I'm staying with you. I refuse. For a younger person that's watching today, I want to encourage you to find some men or women of character and follow them and refuse to leave. Learn all you can. Stay with them. I remember when I was a young man and I was a preacher and I was trying to learn how to be a good pastor. I was underneath a good head pastor. And I asked him one day, I said, is it possible for me to follow you and go to a funeral with you? He looked at me kind of funny, like, you want to go to a funeral with me? I said, I want to learn how to do a funeral. I have never myself done a funeral myself. I need experience. Can I follow you and watch? And the head pastor looked at me and he said, of course, you follow with me. And he told me when he had the next funeral. I went with him and I just sat in the back and I watched how he talked. I watched where he stood. I watched what he read in the Bible. I watched how he touched with the family members. And I learned and learned. And do you know, later, it would be my responsibility. And I would have to preach funerals. And I learned from that man. I have never forgotten those things still today. If you are a younger person, you find a person who has character. You want to copy their behavior and how they do things. Watch what they do. Follow them and refuse to leave. Don't leave. Stay with them. And that's what happened with Elisha. He refused to leave Elijah. Elijah told Elisha that if he stayed with him, God would give him a double blessing. Elijah was truly blessed of God. But he told Elisha that if he stayed with him and he saw him, Elijah, if Elisha saw Elijah go into heaven, that he would have a double blessing. Because of that, Elisha was stubborn, would not leave, and he stayed. It's good for us to know that. Elisha committed that he would follow the man of God. Now understand, as I say this, men will fail. Only God is perfect. But it's important that we find good men and women who we can follow and copy their example. I am still learning, trying to find people who I honor, who I see God working in their life, and I want to copy what they do. I'm still doing it today at my age. I hope you will do the same. We need to find good people. We need to learn from people who have experience and have done things right. Elijah was a good prophet of God. He was faithful. He was true to God. He said tough things in front of important people, but he was faithful to God. Elisha was learning from him all the way through. Good leaders will be willing to teach and to train other people. That is the plan of God. While Elijah and Elisha were walking and talking, something interesting happened. Here's what happened. It says, as they still talked, behold, there appeared a chariot of fire and horses of fire and parted them both asunder. And Elijah went up in a whirlwind into heaven. Do you see the verse? Wow, a miracle happened. Elijah never died. God took him to heaven with this picture. He had the chariot of fire with the horses of fire, and it took him up in a whirlwind, and they went up into heaven. And Elisha, he saw it happen. He was standing, and he saw everything happen. Elijah was taken by God into heaven, and Elisha watched while it happened. Elijah never died. Wow. He was taken into the presence of God with that chariot of fire. He must have been a special prophet, a special man of God. Well, God just took him home to heaven. Elisha, he's watching as it happens. While Elijah went up into heaven, the mantle, you see it here, it's what he would put over him, it fell, and Elisha got the mantle of Elijah. That piece of clothing was a representation of God's power that was passed from Elijah to Elisha, and now he had it. It's important that we see what happens. This was a sign, really it was proof, that the blessing of God that before had been on Elijah would now be on Elisha. And so Elisha begins now. He is the head, kind of the head prophet. He's the most important prophet. The other younger prophets now looked and saw Elisha as the man of God. The kings of Israel would ask for advice from the prophet. The prophet had connection with God. These prophets, you understand, God gave them the ability to see into the future, but he also gave the prophets the ability to explain things God had said in the past. Today, we might call the prophet what? We might call the prophet today the pastor. He was the person who would take the words from God. Today, we call that our Bibles. He would take the Bible and explain it to the people so they could understand what God wanted them to do. He would warn what God gave him. He would warn the people, don't do that, do this, do this, don't do. He would warn. He was a man of God whom God used to explain his heart for the people. And Elisha became that man. The Bible tells us that the many, many wonderful things that happened with Elijah's life now are passed on to Elisha, and twice the blessings, twice the miracles happen in the life of Elisha. Exactly what God promised happened. Elisha became a man of God whom God greatly used, and we see it throughout the book of 2 Kings. The ministry of God did not stop because one man was gone into heaven. I want to tell you today, we must be honest. Too many times we focus on one person, one man. We say, oh, he is important. These other people, not so important. I don't believe that. I believe that God, if one person dies, we say goodbye. We will meet you in heaven again. But God's work continues. I have a friend who has touched in China before, and he's met some Chinese believers there. Some of them have been killed because they believe in Jesus Christ. And you would think, oh, the message of Christ in China is getting less and less and less because Christians are being killed. No, that's not true. As a matter of fact, the Christians in China are growing and growing and growing and increasing because God is in control. I want to tell you today, God will always have a people who will witness for Him and stand for Him. Will you and I be faithful to be a part of that group? I hope you will say, yes, I want to be faithful to God all the way through my life. Well, I want you to see, God had a plan. His plan for leadership back with Elijah and Elisha is the same as His plan for today. God does not want to see the ministry stop or even slow down or even suspended. God wants to see the ministry continue on. When I was a younger man, I was in high school, I ran on the team, the running team, and I was in what they called the relay race. We had four men. One person would start, run, run, run. They would hand off the baton to the second person, run, 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 hand off to the third person. And finally, the last person got to be me. They would hand to me, and I would run, 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 and cross the finish line. The four of us would win or lose together. It's the same in leadership. When I'm running, run, run my race right now, I'm in the middle, I hope, maybe. I'm running right now trying to serve God and do things for God and touch the hearts of deaf people for God, hearing people too. But I'm trying to serve God myself. My hope is that this teaching will not stop with me. But as I teach and film and you're watching and you're deciding, I want my life to be important for God. And I'm passing on to you the things that I have learned in the past myself. I'm giving to you, and I'm hoping that you will take those things into the future, far into the future, and you will hand them to someone else. That's what the ministry is of passing on the Word of God. There are two words that I want to focus on before I close today, and I'm soon finished. There are two words. First is teach. What does it mean to teach? Well, that means I take information that I have gained in my head, and I take it and I give it to your head. I pass my thoughts and my wisdom, my understanding and knowledge, I pass on to you. And you take into your head. And we go on. So we now have information that has been passed from me to you. But the second word that I want to talk about is train. Train. Not train, but train. It's deeper. It's me taking the experiences I have learned in the past and explaining them to you so you catch them and they become your experiences. It's me not just telling you information, but bringing you with me. Say, come with me. Let me show you how to do this. For example, my head pastor years ago, I asked him, can I follow you to the funeral? He said, yes. He could have said to me, no, go back and read this book about how to do a funeral. That would be teaching. That's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. But when my pastor said, yes, come with me next week, have a funeral, come with me. And I followed him. I sat with him in the car. We discussed. I watched him at the funeral with the family. And I heard in the car, I would ask him questions. He would say, oh, I did that because, and he would explain to me. That is training. He is showing me how to do it. It's more than me taking information from here, giving it to your head. It's him taking his life and showing me in my life how to do and learning. We need both teaching and training, both we need. And I want to encourage you. You are part of this process yourself. You are the teacher, the trainer, or you are the student. You are either Elijah or Elisha. We're going to see Elisha next week and few weeks, really, into the future. Some wonderful things happen in his life. We'll study them more deeply. But for right now, as we think about the change of leadership from Elijah to Elisha, I want you to consider yourself. I'm going to ask you three questions, okay, as we close today. First, who are you following? Who? You think about yourself. You say, well, I'm following nobody. Well, you need to find somebody. Find a person who is willing to lead you and follow that person. Second question, who is following you? Some person is behind you. They're following you. Who is that? Are you thinking about, oh, I'm influencing that person. I must be a good example. I must live my life right before God so they are following in the right paths. Some person is following you. Who is that? Third question, will the ministry you have today continue after you are gone? Will the ministry you have today continue after you are gone? That's an important question. I ask myself that question many, many times. I'm praying and praying for God to provide a person to follow me in my ministry right now. Right now, I look back, I don't see a person who will follow me. If I were to die today, my ministry would die also. And that hurts my heart. I'm praying for God to give me wisdom to teach and to train a person to replace me. You should be doing the same. You say, well, Jim Brayson, I'm not in a ministry. Shame on you. Get involved. Serve God. Do something for God. And influence other people to continue after you have gone. Elijah was a good man. But if Elijah only lived his life and did not influence Elisha, the ministry would have dropped right there. But Elijah was faithful to teach and to train Elisha. And we are blessed because of that. The ministry continued. God needs Elijah's, but God also needs Elisha's. We need both the teacher, trainer, and the learner, the follower. We need both. Mature Christians should be looking to teach and train younger Christians. You say, well, Jim Brace, I don't know what to teach or train. Tell them the things you have learned or the things you are right now learning still. Teach them, tell them, share with them. Don't hold it to yourself. If you hold it to yourself and you die, it's buried with you. Tell people what God is teaching you. This is the plan of God for continuing the ministry into future generations. Some deaf ministries stop when the leader, the interpreter, the key deaf person dies, the ministry dies too. That's a shame. It should not happen that way. I want to encourage you to think about who you are following. Second, who you are leading. And third, if your ministry is going to continue after you are gone. Those are three good questions for you to think about today. I hope you will. We need some good, strong, deaf leaders. We need good, strong, deaf followers. We need good hearing leaders and followers the same. Our ministry is dependent on that 2 Timothy chapter 2 thought. The things you have learned, you should pass on to someone else. I want to encourage you to find a person to do that with this next week. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this example here in the Bible of Elijah and Elisha. Thank you for these two men, one the leader, one the follower, who becomes the leader of the next generation. Help us to be ready to follow a good person. Help us to be looking for good people to follow us. And help us to influence others so that our ministry will continue into the future. God, I'm praying personally that you will help me to find some people who will follow me and accept my ministry that I have now. It's your work. I pray that you would help me to find some people who will continue with the work after I am gone. I pray that you will help us be good leaders and followers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for watching. This next week we will see Elisha again with another wonderful widow lady who helps. I will see you next week.